Hello friends, how are you all? My name is Harshit Divedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing with you regarding Gopal Krishna Gokhale, his life's achievements, his role in the Indian freedom struggle. So you can say that this is a sort of biography of Shri Gopal Krishna Gokhale, friends. Previous to this video, I have made video regarding Dada Bhai Neroji. After this, I will be uploading videos related to, you know, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Surendranath Banerjee. So this is presented by me, Harshit Divedi, friends. You can also follow me on my Instagram profile. The link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below. One more thing I want to tell you, friends, is this video is in English. So if you are not comfortable in English, you can go and watch the Hindi version of the video. The link of the Hindi version of the video is also present in the below description. So before starting with Gopal Krishna Gokhale, friends, I have to tell you some basic information about him. He was born on 9th of May 1866. At a place named Kothluk in Ratnagiri district of the then Bombay Presidency, which is now Maharashtra. His father's name was Krishna Gokhale and his mother's name was Valubai. Okay, friends. Now, Gopal Krishna Gokhale was educated at Rajaram High School, Kothapur. Rajaram High School, Kolhapur. And after that, he went to the Elphinstone College. Many things he did, that he was a member of the Indian National Congress, he founded the Servants of India Society. Something like this I will be discussing with you regarding Gopal Krishna Gokhale, friends. You know, one thing you need to know, that he was a leader of socio-political reforms in India. And he did a lot for the Indian National Movement and also for socially awakening the masses of India. Okay. Now, after receiving his early education at Rajaram High School in Kolhapur, he went to 1884 to Bombay to receive higher education. Okay, and in Bombay, he joined the Elphinstone College, Bombay. He did his graduation in arts. After completing his graduation in arts in the Elphinstone College, friends, he went to Poona and took the job of a professor of history and political economy at Ferguson College, Poona. So he became the professor of political economy and history at Ferguson College, Poona, friends. Okay. And, you know, he remained on the in the college for a long amount of time. In 1902, he became the principal of the same college. Now, who was the mentor of Gopal Krishna Gokhale? The Gandhiji's mentor was Gopal Krishna Gokhale. And Gopal Krishna Gokhale's mentor was Mahadev Govind Ranade, who was a scholar, was a jurist. He has a good knowledge in law. So, friends, Gopal Krishna Gokhale was working with Mahadev Govind Ranade, and he was also involved in Poona Sarvajanik Sabha of Mahadev Govind Ranade. Gopal Krishna Gokhale, after some time, became the secretary of Poona Sarvajanik Sabha. Gokhale considered Ranade to be his guru, and Mahadev Govind Ranade helped Gopal Krishna Gokhale to establish Servants of India Society in 1905. They combinedly published a journal whose name was Sarvajanik. Also, friends, what was the aim of this Servants of India Society, friends? The Servants of India Society was a renowned organization which was formed in 1905. It was basically to teach the Indians to rise against social evils and serve their country. That is, instilling a sense of nationalism in the masses of India and also teaching them regarding their rights so that they can widen their horizon, they can know what's happening around them. Okay. Now, the first wife of Gopal Krishna Gokhale was Savitri Bai, with whom he married in 1880, friends. Now, she was suffering from some problems, so she died in 1887 because of congenital ailment. And then he married his second wife, with which he was till 1900, and then her second wife also died. So, after that, he didn't marry, friends. One more important fact about Gopal Krishna Gokhale that you should know, friends, that he became the member of Indian National Congress in the year 1889. After that, he remained the Joint Secretary of Indian National Congress for some years. And then in 1905, he became the President of the Indian National Congress. He was elected as the President of the Indian National Congress at the Benares session of Congress. After 1905 and 1906, who was the President of the Indian National Congress? After that year, Dada Bhai Nehruji was the President of the Indian National Congress. So now, let's see, friends, here. Just connect these dots. Because here it is something very important. The partition of Bengal was announced in 1905. It was also executed then on. Then the Swadeshi movement, okay, the boycott movement was going on. at that point of time, friends. And at that point of time, there was a rift between the extremist and moderate faction of the Indian National Congress. And this moderate faction of the Indian National Congress was led by Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Therefore, 1905, he was elected as the president of Indian National Congress. And in 1906, moderates deliberately elected Dadabhai Nehruji as the president of Indian National Congress. And after that, Raj Bihari Bose was the president of Indian National Congress, elected for two consecutive terms. And actually, there was a sort of split after 1906. Okay, so 1905, Banaras session of Indian National Congress, Gokhale was elected as the president. Okay, now as Gokhale was very much educated, he recognized the importance of the values of democracy, liberty, and the parliamentary system of government. Why? Because parliamentary system of government, you know, allowed the people to vote for their representatives. So he was very much, he knew the importance of that thing at that point of time, at that point of history, because it was the starting of 20th century. Okay, friends. Gokhale was a very prominent force of Indian National Congress at that point of time. He was very, very important in Indian National Congress. He also became a member of the Bombay Legislative Council, friends. And in 1901, he also joined the Imperial Council of the Governor General of India. He was very much vocal about the rights of the Indians, friends. For example, he said he requested the British government to reduce the salt taxes. He requested the British government to reduce the land revenue, to reduce the taxes on cotton goods. So all these type of things he was doing, friends. He was very much focused towards providing the Indians education, especially primary education, free of cost. Then he said that more and more Indians should be given an opportunity to join the Indian civil services, friends. Okay. But there is one more thing, friends. Gokhale only believed in constitutional methods of education. And in 1905, Indian National Congress sent Gokhale to England, you know, to put the constitutional demands of India in front of the British leaders, so that British leaders can come to know that what is happening exactly with the people of India and how to remedy it, as if they didn't know what was happening. So this was basically the methodology of Gokhale. Gokhale believed in constitutional struggle. He believed in the method of prayer, petition, protest. He didn't believe in the extremist ideology. That one was, which was followed by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Okay, friends. Now moving forward. One, Morley Minto reforms came in 1909. From now, we know Morley Minto reforms only for the separate electorate of Muslim thing. But there was much more in Morley Minto reforms, friends. See, the non-official members' numbers were increased in the Legislative Council. This was one very important provision of Morley Minto reforms. And for bringing that provision, Gopal Krishna Gokhale did a lot of work. So despite the fact that this Morley Minto reforms didn't give any democratic system to India, it at least enabled Indians to participate more in the administration, in the governing, the political aspects of administration. Now, when Gokhale ji joined International Congress, there were many more leaders who were joining International Congress, and they were also very influential, like Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, okay, Annie Besant. So what was happening, friends, that as Gokhale was a moderate, his ideology was not matching with the extremist ideology, which was especially led by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Gokhale was a progressive person. He was not very much into the customs of the Indian society, whereas Bal Gangadhar Tilak was actually very educated, but he believed in the customs of India. He was very religious. So what happened, that there came an act which was named as Age of Consent Bill. Now what this Age of Consent Bill did, that previously the age of girls that can be married legally was less. This Age of Consent Bill increased that minimum age. Now, this thing was very much liked by Gokhale, and Gokhale supported the British government at this step. And this was a progressive step. But Bal Gangadhar Tilak said that why are the Britishers interfering in our personal affairs? So Bal Gangadhar Tilak, that whatever Britishers are doing is not right. So Gokhale and Bal Gangadhar Tilak was a very, you know, they were very divisive at this, at what should be done on this Age of Consent Bill. Okay, so the rift was out and open. There was a big rift, big clash between Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Gopal Krishna Gokhale. And this rift was at its peak in 1906, when the Surat split was there and the party got divided into the moderate faction and the extremist faction. One more thing with which Bal Gangadhar Tilak was involved was the Servants of India Society, friends. Bal Gangadhar Tilak, as I said, was a firm believer in education. He thought that when the people are educated, it will be very difficult for anyone to befool them. If a people is educated, his thought process, his mind, his whole, you know, understanding will be on a very wide level. He would be able to see beyond what is happening in front of him. His wide horizons will be widened. And if Indians are educated, they will come to know about their civic duties, administrative duties, political duties, legal duties. Whatever he has to do, he would know it. That is why Gopal Krishna Gokhale formed the Servants of India Society. The aim of this Servant of India Society is to educate common people about what is happening in India, what is the administrative scenario, what is the political scenario of India, and also instill in Indians a feeling of nationalism towards their country. And for this, he built schools, he built free night classes, he built a mobile library where the people could come, they would study, and they will also take away with them some of the ideologies that Gokhale was trying to propound through his agenda. Okay, now Gokhale was a big mentor also, friends, and he was mentor to both Gandhiji and also to Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So I will deal with both of them differently. Gokhale first met Gandhiji in 1896. And then in 1901, they again met, and they were with each other for almost 1 month in Calcutta in 1901. Now, when Gokhale talked to Gandhiji, Gandhiji at that time was in South Africa. He was leading some movements in South Africa. Gokhale said to Gandhiji that you should come back to your country. Okay. Now, when Gokhale met Gandhiji in 1896, that was the time when Gandhiji was going to England. Okay. Then in between, Gandhiji came back. Okay. So, when Gandhiji met Gokhale, Gokhale said to Gandhiji that you should come back to your own country and fight for the people of India by joining the Indian National Congress. Whatever Gandhiji was doing in South Africa, some amount of help was also available from the side of Gopal Krishna Gokhale. For example, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, arranged for some money for the Gandhiji's efforts in South Africa. Gopal Krishna Gokhale also went to South Africa in 1912, and there he met Gandhiji and some other African leaders. So obviously Gokhale was a mentor to Gandhiji. Gandhiji saw Gokhale as its mentor. Now what is happening that there were some differences in between the thought process of Gandhi and Gokhale also. Gokhale was very much in favor of constitutional struggle, and he was a firm believer in the institutions of the Britishers. But Gandhiji were not very much firm in the institutions of British government. The established institutions of British government, that was something in which Gokhale has firm belief. Like courts, like police stations, administrative machinery. But Gandhiji was not that much a big believer in administrative machinery. So this was the difference, friends. Then Muhammad Ali Jinnah was also a big follower of Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Muhammad Ali Jinnah called himself the Muslim Gokhale, and he was said to be, the ambassador of Hindu-Muslim unity. But after that, you will see that a lot of bad things are going to happen. Okay. Now, Gokhale was very much dedicated to the cause of Indian nationalism, friends. But he was, at the end of his life, suffering from diseases like diabetes, cardiac, asthma. Okay. And the pressure on his mind aggravated these problems. And he passed away on 19th of February 1915. So he was basically an inspiration for the people of India. Despite of being a moderate, he did a lot for his country. And one most important contribution of Gokhale towards this country is that he proposed free and compulsory education through his elementary education bill in 1910. There was one elementary education bill in 1910 which Gokhale proposed. In that he said that free and compulsory education would be there, and 100 years after it, in 2010, Right to Education Act came, which made primary education a fundamental right for people. So this was one big contribution of Gokhale to the national cause. So this was the biography of Gokhale, friends. Some important things about Gokhale. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was really helpful for you, kindly subscribe to my channel, friends. Give it some likes. Also, if you don't like the video, kindly hit the dislike button and tell me that why you didn't like the video. And I would request you, friends, kindly refer these videos more and more to your friends. The more people are going to watch this video, the more helpful it will be for me. So thank you for watching, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye.